All right, welcome all. Return to the USG Ishimura tonight. We are playing Dead Space, as you well know. This is episode 2 of my Dead Space Let's Play for 0 HP. And we're going to go ahead and continue, be a little bit longer tonight. Nothing crazy. Each one will get just a tiny bit longer than the last one. I think the last one checked in about 16, 17 minutes. So we should be able to get this done. Oh, I'd say about 20 minutes or so. Somewhere in that range. We'll see how we go. Isaac's all, what the fuck was that? Which is what you're generally supposed to be like when you're playing this game. So let us continue. So last time, let's go quick on a recap here. Story-wise, we have to get the trams back online. There's a train that's being blocked and the whole system is offline, and we have to grab a backup chip. Or a data pad or something like that, what's it called here? Need a data board to fill in all of the route information for the train. So that's what we're doing. Just going all Isaac, gonna go fix stuff, go attack the horde monsters. Here we go. Let's do it, guys. All right. Oh man, I miss this game so much. Okay. Oh, we got some goodies down here. Let's check it out down here. Oh, I remember this. This guy's not dead. Watch this. Watch this. See? Oh, anyway. Got you. Alright, I'm an over-saver, so I'm going to save again. I'm going to save just a few seconds ago. I was reading some... I was reading a little bit about the PC version of this game having some issues. Oops. Some issues with the PC port on this game, that the controller sensitivity, regardless of mouse or controller, is really hard to get right. I guess it's like the V-Sync. It's capping you out at 30 frames a second, which is what I have my... Let's turn it up one and see how that does. But it's also kind of hard to control the mouse. So I do see what they're saying, so hopefully we can get that fixed.
This is Benson, Tram Engineering. We think we figured it out. Smith killed one. Listen, forget about shooting him in the body. You gotta cut off the limbs. Grab a cutter, anything like that. Cut him apart!
Since there aren't really any tutorials in the game, they're really heavy-handed with telling you, hey, look, shoot the limbs, shoot the legs, or you're gonna die a horrible, violent, graphic death. That was actually a huge thing about this game. The way Isaac can be just absolutely torn to pieces is something else. Man, come on, bro. You scaring me like that.
Isaac, be careful. Shooting them in the body didn't seem to work. Go for the limbs. Dismember them. That should do the job.
This is their fifth time telling me.
Dismembering enemy limbs and doing extra damage.
Roger that. Let's do it. Let's start cutting off limbs.
Man. This is crazy. Okay. Continue on now. Alright, so... That is our stasis meter.
Slow down, fast objects and enemies.
Looks like that door is malfunctioning, Isaac. Try using the stasis module you just picked up.
Yes, indeed. I shall. Ooh. So I'll slow the door down. Let us get in here. Okay. Continue on. So these vents, this is where they pop out. But you never really know when they're going to pop out. Yeah. Oh, save station. Let's do it. These get a little more sparsely placed throughout the world as the game continues. I'm giving you a false sense of security right now. Okay, let's go down here. Son of a bitch.
Hello?
stasis module should be able to help you with that arm mechanism.
This is the first little kind of puzzle of the game. And this is a whole other system. So power nodes, you can either use them to bust open doors like that are full of loot. Or you can use them to upgrade Isaac's armor, like his armor, his hit points, there's a few other, the amount of stasis he has, things like that. So it's kind of like a risk reward, you know, do you want to use it to bust this door open, or what do you want to do? So, stasis, run, lock, oh shit. These guys. Stop now! I think another one's gonna sneak up on me. Pretty sure there's another one coming up on me. I don't know. It's been way too long since I played this game. So we should probably reload. We have 3 rounds in.
Listen up, car 8 is trashed. We managed to get it back to the repair depot, but now the autoloader is fried. I need a stasis module brought down here now. If we don't get this piece of shit off the tracks, it's gonna jam up the whole system.
Oh, shit! Fuck you. Oh, I was listening to an audio track. You can't jump at me while I'm listening to an audio track. Son of a bitch. Okay. By the way, I'm gonna curse a lot while I'm playing this game. So just be warned. This is the one that doesn't attach very long, so you gotta freeze it. Initiate. Okay, now I get attacked.
Replacing damage tram car. Please stand by.
Oh, stand by. You mean be prepared to hold block even launches, okay? Yes. That's
Isaac,
what you mean.
You did it. The tram is blocking the whole system. When you get the computer online, you'll be able to call the tram from the control room. Faster the better. I can hear something crawling around out there.
Yeah, I see you.
Complete.
Mess with me right now? Anybody want to mess with me right now? Can I pick up my ammo over there? I think so. Smoosh this guy. Smooshing enemies with your boot, like so. Can give you extra ammo. It's very realistic. I'm not gonna shoot at you. I know I can't hit you behind. Oh god. This is gonna be fine. Please don't turn the lights off again. I should probably do a second save. I'll do a second file next time. That's still locked. Of course, the bathrooms are unlocked. Bathrooms are always so... Why are bathrooms and med bays always so scary in horror games? Well, it's worth it. I got some ammo. This bathroom's not so scary. Alright, everybody. Time to check where we're supposed to go. Back to where we came from. Okay. Reloaded. Yep. Got 10 rounds. Oh, yeah. That's the other thing you can use. Those power nodes for upgrades. Armor, his armor, health, stasis, and his guns. The weapons that you pick up, you can upgrade. Slow down. Don't. Oh, fuck me. Usually what happens at this game is that they'll distract you attack you right in the front.
Oh, okay. Never mind.
They'll distract you by attacking you directly, obviously, in the front, and then some other bastard will pop up behind you. And you're so worried with what's in front of you, and then all of a sudden you just grab him behind you, like, you gotta, like, rip him off. And it's a heart attack. And I'm beginning to understand why people are bitching about the V-Sync on this game.
Isaac, I've patched into the deck security system. It took some work, but I've got the door to the maintenance bay unlocked. The data board should be somewhere inside. Isaac, you still need to find the data board to the tram computer. It's in the maintenance bay.
Maintenance bay. All right. Also, that was locked last time when I came back over here. Already dealt with this guy. Let's go ahead and save again. I'll do a second save file, as I promised. Okay. And then we'll head out to the maintenance bay. This just doesn't look so good. Oh, elevator. Okay.
Isaac, it's Kendra. Looks like the door to the storage room is locked. There should be a key somewhere in the maintenance bay.
All right, so get a key. Back to what I was saying earlier, the V-Sync that I keep talking to, seeing, makes it a little, the aim, it's just either like way too sensitive or it's not sensitive enough. It might create some problems for me later on. Yes, I see you. There's a shit. Oh shit. I'm trying to talk. Someone coming behind me? Bastards. Ah! Jesus, dude. I don't believe you're actually dead. Now I believe you're actually dead. Sometimes they're fake death. Because they're just rude like that. It's just so inconsiderate. The less weapons you carry on you at any given time will give you more ammo for that one. Ooh, I got an achievement in my 360 way back when. You can just play the whole game with a plasma cutter. It's one of my favorite weapons of all time. Its simplicity, its power. You know, and it does exactly what you need it to do as far as you just switch the way it aims and it's better to do. So here is legs, boom, arms. I don't know, just gets the job done. And you can beat bosses with it, you know, upgrade it. I don't know if I'll do that in this game because I know a lot of you who may be watching have never seen the game before. I will most likely switch it up a little bit. I don't need that health. Somebody else, Jesus. Alright, it wants me to go in the elevator, so we must have to go get the key in the elevator first. I love the artwork. This game actually has a really, really cool, just like fascinating universe that gets much more heavily explored in the second and third games, which are also fantastic. They weren't quite the masterpieces like this, but they weren't like this. Oh, you're cute. You're cute. Lying down. I don't buy that. Your Dead Space veteran. That kind of stuff does not get me. Some money. Should have you hit up a store here soon. Oh, shit. conservation at its finest. And you know, I've heard other criticisms about, oh, it's cheap jump scares, whatever. And it does. It employs some classic, just, you know, basic old jump. You're not dead. Yeah, you hear them screaming? But they still scream. It's really just more the atmosphere. And these creatures are horrifying. Globs of mangled human flesh. I mean, it's disturbing. And the universe, the sound in this game, all the background sounds, and just the way the camera angles have hugged in on him. So, I mean, it just creates tension throughout its universe, and the way that they show you the game, show you the world, is almost scarier than the actual jump scares that happen. Okay, the jump scares are just fine. Oh! They work, though. Cheap or not, they work. Even all these years later, after beating this game that many times. Alright, well. That goes boom, so I'll keep that there. I'm sure someone will pop in behind me. Yeah, once we start finding more advanced enemies, I'm a little worried that this aiming is going to be difficult. There it is. And the locked door. We got a power node, workbench. That's where we upgrade everything. Oh, it's not locked. I have the key. Well, you know what? I'm gonna go over here first because I'm pretty sure I'm gonna get ambushed after I get the keys. Over here, collect some ammo. Is that a way back? Is that the elevator? Is that the way back? Yeah, that's the way back. So we'll stop spilling stuff in the background. I'm not gonna collect the key yet, because that usually getting objective sets off. Okay. So I don't need the health, I haven't been hurt yet. So. Oh, sound effect. All those sound effects, though.
Use power nodes to upgrade your weapons and rig.
Understood. Alright everyone, so this is our workbench. This is a huge part of the game. Huge, I say. Oh god, don't worry, I won't do any more Jar Jar Binks like that. I usually like upgrading my rig. I want to get those hit points. Now this was the kind of frustrating thing, is you have to like get these empty worthless nodes to get to the good ones, which is so annoying. But I'm just gonna put a node right there. I'm going to go to Plasma Cutter, and we'll go ahead and start with straight-up damage. Let's just make it do a little bit more oomph. I usually didn't use the nodes to open doors unless I was really looking for equipment or supplies, because, I don't know, I found it better to upgrade everything. Okay, who's going to attack me in a minute? Going to attack her.
That's it, Isaac. Take the board back to tram control and slot it into the computer array. That should get the tram system back online.
I saw you coming. Fuck. Goddamn. These are screams. They're unholy screams of pain. Kind of reminds me of Last of Us, you know? They're infected and they're completely past humanity. Oh, really? Like in Last of Us, their screams, they can tell they're like still human and they're suffering when they're. And I feel like the same way some of the Zekomorphs are still like. They're just screaming all this anger and pain. It's like the human's still somewhere trapped in there underneath the alien. It's sort of like an alien. I don't know, it's kind of like a. Not really a virus, it's like its own. Microbial life! Microbial life! Die! Jesus freaking Christ, man. I think we're just going straight back. I don't think I need to save again. Oh, fuck it. I'll save. I can't help it, guys. It's just an impulse. It's just a pure impulse. Oh, this is where I came in and ran, and he ran past here. Okay. What the fuck was that? What the hell? Did you guys see that? Tell me you saw that, and I'm not just being a scared little bitch right now. Let's go check it out. That's the one I killed. I think he was walking this way, down this hall. Whatever. You know what? He can attack me if he wants to. Oh, come on, door. I remember this kind of being like a safe room. A safe place to hide. Alright, we'll go ahead and replace the data board, save, and that'll end our episode. Let's go ahead and do it.
Computer now online. Shipwide tram system reinitialized. All trams now operational. Tram arriving at flight deck station. Quarantine lifted.
We got the tram back online.
Alright, we're on board and heading to the bridge. Good work.
Strange. The quarantine just lifted.
Whatever was in the flight lounge must have left. That's lucky for us. Isaac, get back to the Kellion and prep it for launch. We'll find out what we can from the bridge and meet you there.
If we live that long... You're out of your league, Hammond. This is suicide. We're going
your
to die out
here. Your lack of confidence in me is duly noted, Miss Daniels. But I have a mission to complete, and that's exactly what I am going to do, with or without you. Do we understand each other?
Just get us out of here alive.
You were just complaining about how we couldn't do that. So which one do you want? Fucking A. Alright, tram en route. So we're gonna go try and prep that broken-ass ship up for launch. I guess it still can fly. And so let's go ahead and save. Save. Right here. Chapter 1, new arrivals. Yes. Save. And that'll be it. That's going to end our episode, everyone, of Dead Space. And there's Isaac with a smear of blood on his face. So we're going to get into it again for episode 3. We're going to go try and prep that Kellion for launch. I'm sure nothing will go wrong with that plan at all. And we'll make it out. We'll all survive and just forget this ever happened. Happy ending coming up in episode 3. Till then, thank you for joining me and Samurai Jack. I should say Samurai Jack and I, but I just like introducing him second because he's a mannequin and I'm a real person when I come first. So, all right, guys, we'll catch you next time. Thank you so much for watching Zero HP's stream of, or not stream, this is a Let's Play. Let's Play of Dead Space.